I'm calling the series Transformers Reanimated. That's where me, Mitch Santona, your Transformer reviewing buddy from the internet, takes a look at all of my animated line. I'm going through all of them, man. I'm going to see if I can get through the entire Transformers animated line. It's Transformers Leader Class Megatron. Sorry I haven't said that earlier. I'm sure you know by now and by the title, so you know where you're at and what we're looking at today. Just look at this attack helicopter. It is just gorgeousness. Absolute gorgeousness. It's a big old giant animated looking cartoony attack helicopter. Two double rotor blades here that you can see. Look at them go. You spin one, the other one goes so they don't collide. Some magic happening there. There's some geared system going on. Super cool. Lots of cool gimmicks on this thing. I just love the leader classes in this line. We're going to look at this guy. We'll get him transformed and stuff. And I've got some comparisons and stuff to show you too. So as of right now, you know, we got lights and sounds. We can go like this. Listen to that, man. Got the little choppy, choppy noise. Got the light up gimmicks here. So cool. And he's got a little blaster cannon here. I'll get you the missile in a second. We'll look at that in robot mode. But the missile will fire. It'll shoot out. I took it out because it's real touchy. But man, look at it. Landing gear. You can deploy them. You can go like this, set him back up, and then he flies right out of frame, and you cut. I got a little comparison here for you. This is Shadowblade Megatron. I've not seen this in any of the media except for this toy. And I don't know what it's in reference to, but it's just a recolor of Megatron that's really neat. I'm going to look at him a little bit more up close because it's you got to appreciate this, man. This paint deco is really cool, too. So in lieu of the red cockpit, he's got like a purple color. It's really cool. The purples here are all metallic and beautiful looking. Here's his missile. We'll put that back in. So it's got a real nice contrast with that black. It almost looks like a Skywarp deco. You can kind of see that shining and just looking all silvery and beautiful. He does have also the same gimmick here. Working lights. He's got the little red LED that goes off. Gives you a little helicopter noises in this mode. We'll get him transformed side by side with the other one, and we'll check them out both. Now, this is not supposed to scale with one another, but they do look real nice together if you sit them on here on a shelf in vehicle mode. It's about that time where we do it up. There it is, man. Evoking that cartoon like you wouldn't believe. Very cartoony, very cartoon accurate, and just a nice, big, bulky, massive. Get your hands on it. It's a nice, rugged toy. You mess around with it. You mess about with it, and you have some fun, man. That's what this is all about. And that's what I'm doing here. Now, the only downfall is a lot of the animated line has some weird quirks, some kind of weird articulation points on some of them, and some of them have some weird little nuanced things. This guy in particular has some weird knees, like he's just a little bit on the knock-kneed side, so it may turn you off if you're looking at it and staring at it enough. He looks a little bit like it looks a little weird. You can kind of cheat it a little and just spread them out a bit, make them look a little bit better if you can. But for the most part, I think this is pretty stellar. So you saw me messing around with these double-bladed helicopter rotors. Really cool they become these swords that he can dual-wield. And I always like my Megatron to dual-wield swords, right? I think you want everybody to dual-wield swords. I guess if I had a choice right now between reviewing something and dual-wielding swords, it would be close. Before these batteries die, let's do the gimmick. So check this out. When you push on the Decepticon symbol, which is red, I kind of would like that to be purple, but whatever. We'll push on this and check it out. He's got some facial animations, lights, and sounds. Look at that, man. That's so cool. Look at it.
Where is the old spark?
Where is the old spark?
The old spark.
Pretty sure that's Corey Burton's voice too. I love it. The little head crest comes down, the mouth opens, and there, and it's asymmetrical too. I don't know if you noticed that or not, but it is purposefully cut like that to look more animated. That's so neat. We got to run down posability for Sports Wolf. This is the time and the review to do it. Now, he's got some weird, I don't know what this is about. Like, you can kind of almost flap his arms around. Like, the wings flap and kind of do that. I don't know why. I don't know what that's for. Someone in the comments tell me. But listen to the ratchets. It's ratchets for days. I love it. I love it to pieces. Everything's all clunky and chunky when it's moving around. Lots of things move on this guy, including the waist. Doesn't have a full waist swivel, but he's got enough. He's got enough to count it. He's got some hip skirts here. He could do this. Kick you right in the mouth. Kick you right in the face if you like. Oh, look at this. Be still my heart. The amount of posability on this guy is absolutely excellent. The kicking and clicking and high kicking is just phenomenal. And he's got a bunch of foot movement here for all those iconic Megatron toe posings. All right, in the transforming montage, you saw me rip the bottom of the cockpit right off of this guy. It is now part of his arm. You just clip it right onto the side of his arm, and it does come with a missile. So we're going to plug the missile in and see if we can get this to fire. I'm not sure. This is an old toy with old springs. We will try it here. Oh, it's in there, okay? And I think what you do is you just grab this, and you should be able to squeeze. You should be able to squeeze that, or there we go. You pull it that way and it shoots. I can't remember. This is old, man. Comparison time. Here's Leader Bulkhead. There he is with Voyager Optimus. And now this was the scale of these two in the cartoon. Megatron was much bigger. There he is with a more recent offering. Here he is side by side with Shadowblade Megatron. And we're going to eliminate this guy for a second. We are going to focus in on this because I do want to show off this deco. Something we didn't ask for, that we didn't really need, but I did. I needed it. It's good, man. It's so nice looking. It's such a beautiful paint job. It really took well to all these purples and silvery purples and metallic purples and silvers. And oh, man, the contrast, the beauty of this thing. It really is an impressive looking thing, and I'm so happy to have this years later. I'm wondering why they did it. I don't care. This guy doesn't care. Give me more. You want to do it again? Do it again, man. Reissue this guy with another deco. I'll buy it. Just to show this off too. All the gimmicks work on him as well. Something else to point out, if you have your Leader Bulkhead and you got your Headmaster gimmick, then you know that these will plug in and take over the bodies of all the Leader class Transformers. I don't know if this works on Megatron, though. We're going to see. Certainly doesn't sound like it. No, it doesn't. Usually he says total ownage or something weird, but you can fit it on top of him. We'll show this off on the original flavored Megatron, too. Again, it doesn't do anything. It does sit on there so you can walk around with the Headmaster unit if you like, but doesn't make any different noises. We got Transformers Animated Leader Class Megatron in the books. And we also took a look at Shadowblade Megatron too. So check it off, man. You got the check sheet, you got the scorecard going. Check it off the list. We got Animated Megatron in the books. I still got Voyagers and Deluxes to look at too, so we'll see them all here on this channel. Stick around for more animated. Stick around for more Thursday throwbacks. Got some G1 goodies. Got some recent stuff coming your way. And a whole bunch of other things. Blockies and model building. And a whole sorts of Transformers related goodness. Take care. Thanks for watching. Arrivederci, babies. And you guys have a good one.